I'm going to introduce our speaker. We've been talking over the last several weeks, and I really thank God for her. Susie Marsh is a licensed social worker. I don't know what the C stands for.
Clinical.
Licensed clinical social worker. Susie began her career in 1983 as an inpatient drug counselor for adolescents. In 1992, Susie completed her master's degree in social work from Ohio State University, where she had been working in the field of codependency. Since 1993, Susie has been in private practice helping groups, families, teens, and adults face their issues and create positive change. In addition to private practice, she is a public speaker. She hosts her own mental health radio show on WSB 98.5 FM and is working towards a community TV show for families. Susie's most impressive personal credential for teaching people about change is the fact that she recovered from teenage drug and alcohol addiction at age 23. Her philosophy of life and training was stolen from a bumper sticker, "Let's put the fun back in dysfunctional." I'd like to introduce you to Susie Marsh.
Thank you. Thanks. I hope I can make this lavalier work. Thank you so much for having me here today. I'm really grateful and honored to be doing this. This is part of my life that I love all of my life, but I really love speaking and doing what I consider prevention work. Whatever you see in your child at age 2, you can multiply that at age 12. So, if it's bad, it'll be really bad. At age 4, times 5 at age 14. So I am going to teach you about what happens and how you can change behavior no matter what. I have to tell you a little bit about what happened to me. Now stick with me until you get to the end of the story, okay? You can judge me, but wait till the very end, okay? When I was 2 years old, as the family story goes, I was 2 years old and my mom was giving my brother and I a bath. And she turns around to reach for the shampoo. She turns back, and I am gone in 2 seconds. She looks around. I have shimmied up to the top of the curtain rod. That's the first time I remember hearing, "Susan Elizabeth Marsh!" A couple years later, I'm 4 years old. I'm in the living room, and my father won't talk to me because he's reading the paper. So I sat there for a few minutes. Finally, when he wouldn't listen, I hauled off and kicked him in the shins as hard as I could. That was the first time I heard my dad scream my name. So, when I was 16, I had bad behavior. I loved attention. I loved excitement. And I loved danger. Now, I'm not proud of this, but it was the 70s, and we lived in Athens, Georgia, so that was a college town. And streaking and mooning were popular. So I wanted to be the first in my crowd. I'm ashamed. Now, you know how you do that. Well, a lot of y'all don't know how to do that. But some of your kids do. You roll the window down, drop your trousers. I know. Press ham. Shoot a moon. Forgive me. And luckily he did much later. I discovered at age 16 that I could do this much quicker and much easier when I was wearing my cheerleading uniform.
Yeah.
Is it any wonder I got kicked off cheerleading? That was before I even did drugs. I know. So after I started doing drugs, I started hanging out with a crowd that was much worse than the cheerleaders. And my parents tried. They really tried. My father, Dr. Professor Marsh, an educator, would use lectures for discipline. He would lecture. And I'd plan my weekend. My mother, now, I don't know if y'all know Catholics, Our Lady of Perpetual Humiliation. What do Catholics like best? Y'all know what they respond to? Guilt. So when my mom would try to discipline me, what do you think she was trying to use? After she would rationalize, moralize, philosophize all the time, trying to guilt trip me, at the end of her 20-minute lecture, discipline lecture, she would be feeling very guilty. And she would be crying. And I'd be fine. Now, I believe that I had attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Y'all hear about that? It's the diagnosis du jour. Well, I still think I had it. My parents still say, Susie, you weren't ADHD, you were BAD. And it started way before age 16. One day, something in my family happened. One day, something changed. Now, by this time, we've got the whole pattern and the scenario set for discipline behavior, over and over and over. It's the same thing. So I remember this day clearly. There's two days that I remember very clearly. The other one I'll tell you on the second half. I remember it being a sunny day. I remember being in my bedroom, being on the phone with my girlfriends, making weekend plans with the twins, hanging up the phone, running downstairs to tell my mom my weekend plans. Mom, Laura and Lydia and I are going to go to Underground Atlanta this weekend with Chicken Hawk and Bird Dog. Is this a guy thing? To nickname each other after animals? Okay. My mom's at the kitchen cooking. Laura and Lydia's parents may not care about them, but my daughter, I care about you. You are not going to Underground Atlanta. You are too young. But then my heart started pounding and I had to turn around, had to run up the stairs as quick as I could because I didn't want her to see me smiling. I remember being in my bedroom, wondering why I could not stop smiling. I never questioned her about that. I never argued. Unfortunately, I did continue to use drugs, but I never forgot my mother's strength and love that day. For the first time, I was the kid, and she was the adult. For the first time, I couldn't shake her. She was a mountain. She didn't feel any guilt. I felt totally safe. So Smart Discipline is here today. The first hour, we're going to teach you what my mother knew that day. Behavior, bad behavior, is behavior asking for discipline. B-A-D. Now, I've been a therapist for 18 years. I'm going to tell you, 90% of the families that I see, that scenario is what I see. B-A-D behavior is behavior asking for discipline. You're only going to remember 10% of tonight unless you repeat this with me. You might remember the jokes, but I want you to repeat this with me. Let's say it together. B-A-D behavior is behavior asking for discipline. Now you might remember 80%. In education, we know that what you repeat, you have a better chance of remembering. So if I can remember not to talk so much, now I do have a radio show, so obviously I like to listen to myself. So if I can stop myself, I'm going to try to do some exercises to get you to remember what I'm teaching. Because when I did get sober at age 23, I knew what God did ordain me to do. I knew why I was alive. I should be dead. And my husband says the way I drive, I should still be dead. But I have angels watching me. And the years that I did use drugs, things got much worse. And I found out what I'm here for. And I'm preaching to the choir. When I come to my workshops and there's people that show up as much as you guys are showing up, half the time, they already know half of this, if not all of it. It's the families that aren't here. It's the families that end up in my office when it gets too bad, like it has had gotten in my family. So Smart Discipline is here to teach you how to erase negative behavior, and you cannot do that without discipline. The second hour, we're going to talk about making new behavior, and you can't do that without love. And Hebrews, and I can't remember, I was raised Catholic, so you know, we didn't read the Bible until I grew up and married an evangelical. My husband was raised evangelical, so he says, Susie, go read the Bible. So there's an incredibly great, and I'm going to put it on an overhead, there's a wonderful scripture in Hebrews, and it's all about discipline, that you, and some of y'all can probably quote it, that you respect your father, and he, if he loves you, he will discipline you. If he loves you, he will discipline you. And all the teenagers that come to my office whose parents did what my parents did have no respect. And even worse, they disrespect themselves. So the first thing I want you to do is I want you to think about discipline in terms of rules and laws. Because when we grow up in society and we know how to follow laws in society, we don't get in trouble. Well, I didn't know how to follow rules, so I did get in trouble a lot when I grew up before I got healthy. So you want your children to grow up and leave home and be able to function out in society. Or they're going to stay home and never leave and raise their children there. I know, you say, if they make it alive. So think of your home similar to society. Think of all the things that are bugging you about the behavior. And I'm going to tell